Tremendously competitive with great attention to detail, David. Thanks. We're down the back stretch here, Steve. Certain lottery teams are now giving more minutes to younger players. Of course, that affects their ability to compete and brings up a whole slew of questions.
Yeah, Kevin, it does. I think, obviously, you can tinker with the rotation. You can tinker with playing different guys. But I think fans and, obviously, people who love the game, they don't want to see the 12th man starting to be the number one option. I think you can lessen some of your starters' minutes and increase some of your bench players' minutes, but I don't think teams want to just see a reversal on how you rotate your players. That's when you start to get upset.
And pride has got to matter here too a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. And I think that's where you have the superstars on your team. They got to come out and say, I want to play every night.
Here's the starting group for Houston. Paul and Harden are the incredible backcourt duo. Gorden is out there with P.J. Tucker, and it's Capella in at the center, locking down the middle. Here's Lowry. Knocks down the 10-footer.
A nice make there from Lowry in the mid-range. He can do some damage from there.
Harden against Green. Harden kicks to Gorden. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Gordon's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Paul against Lowry. Over Paul. And Lowry gets it to go.
Lowry on the pick and roll draws so much attention because he is so good at finishing the play himself.
Paul outside. Now the feed to Capella. Over Ibaka. Again the Rockets score.
Well, this gives you some confidence when you drop three straight to start the game.
Lowry against Paul. So first quarter, just over a minute and a half in. Shoots a fader, and the Raptors tack on two more.
Kyle Lowry with great vision and court awareness on that play. What a pass.
Last game for the Rockets, they picked up the win against the Miami Heat.
And the difference on that night, their ability to knock down triples.
What they did, they made a serious effort to generate good shots along the perimeter. Extremely accurate.
Siakam passes to Ibaka, and there's the foul. It'll go on P.J. Tucker. That's his first foul. So it's Toronto now, trailing by two. Lowry looking around, six to shoot. And Serge Ibaka, the bucket on the assist by Lowry.
A lot of enthusiasm to the start of this game. So far, a perfect 4-for-4.
Harden against Green from past the arc. Here's Capella. And that one is off. Some solid defense from Ibaka. And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. That is his first foul of the game. Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. A nice shot by Tucker. Tucker's got six.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open.
Paul with the steal. And it's Houston on the break. Paul with the ball. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
You know, it tells you something about Harden that he's led the league in free throw attempts so many times. This man is always in attack mode. And James Harden, last season's MVP, the runner-up in 2015, actually won the players' vote for MVP that season. But last season, he took home the official hardware.
First free throw is good. And with James Harden winning the MVP in 2018, Russell Westbrook in 2017, Kevin Durant in 2014, you think a few what-ifs right now in Oklahoma City?
A few, but more than that, Kevin. I mean, probably tough for them all to win MVP playing on one team. A good shot at a different trophy, though, maybe the one that starts with the name of Larry.
and both free throws good for James Harden.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
Green inside, guarded by Harden. Here's Siakam, buries it from three-point range. Siakam's got himself going there, his first points of the game on the deep ball. Houston in the lead. Harden with it. We saw him go on a scoring rampage last game. Over Green. Another miss by Houston.
Wow, he had it at point-blank range, but the defense was all over him.
Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Outstanding entry pass there. He knew exactly where to go with the ball.
And it's Paul with the ball for the Houston Rockets. Harden outside. Passes to Capella. Tries again, and the layup is up and in. Capella's got his second basket.
And that's a great play on the backboard for him. I mean, it's what we expect. All his second chance points do not come by accident.
Lowry finds Ibaka. And again, Toronto with the triple.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Of their last five baskets, three have been triples.
Paul outside. Down low. Trying to find Capella. Gets it to him. An emphatic alley-oop jam.
The eyes of Chris Paul. He's always had tremendous vision.
And that Unleash Chaos replay presented by Under Armour. Hover Havoc, giving us a chance to relive that exciting play. Leonard on the wing, defended by Gorden. Unloads from 13. Leonard, no luck.
Ah, nice move inside. Has the defender beat. Just fails to finish.
Gorden dishes to Paul. Harden outside. And again for three.
And his incredible shooting season continues.
Oh, up the history charts he climbs, GA. Now tied for third all-time for threes in a season. Absolutely amazing.
And he has now matched the mark from 2015 when Curry hit 286 threes. Just an incredible year, as he has been absolutely lethal from beyond the arc all season.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Rockets. That one was played down in Houston.
It was a loss last time they faced up against each other, a very tightly contested game that they felt they could have won.
It could have gone either way, but unfortunately for them, they ended up on the losing side of that score.
And a quick look at how things have been since the All-Star break, checking out the three-point shot ratio for the Rockets.
And clearly they haven't been shy about launching it from long range. That's the way the league has been going, and they are certainly embracing that trend.
Lowry against Paul. Now here's Lowry. He's coming off a 19-point game against Portland.
And his defense was absolutely outstanding, especially his two blocks, which helped turn the game.
Shot clock at two. There's Green with the three. And again, no good by Toronto.
Just enough coverage to bother that three-point attempt.
Gorden kicks to Paul. Here's Harden on the wing. Back to Capella. Another shot. And he sinks the layup. Capella's got 8 points.
That's all confidence right there. He knows he's in a groove, and they've got this team on its heels.
The pass to Ibaka. Now here is Lowry. They need this. Paul grabs the board. Rockets leading by five. Well, Steve, when you look at the core of this Raptors team, all in their prime to late prime.
The window is closing for this group. The team should definitely feel a sense of urgency on making the most of this opportunity.
Harden against Green. Back to Lowry. Takes a three. It's rebounded by Houston. Capella's got his sixth rebound on the night. To the paint. Here's Tucker. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. 8 points for him.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Tipped away. Down low, Harden. There it is, his second make of the game. He's missed five.
And boy, have they come out strong, really pounding the offensive board for second chance points.
Toronto calls timeout, fresh from a win against Portland.
I just thought the defense was porous. Got any shot they wanted, really, for most of the evening.
I'll give them credit. Even though they were facing very little resistance, they refused to play down to the level of their competition.
And Toronto will go for a different look here. Marc Gasol's checked in for Ibaka. OG Anunoby comes in for Pascal Siakam. Powell, he's checked in for Danny Green. And it's Jeremy Lin in for Kyle Lowry. And then for Houston, Kenneth Faried's checked in for Clint Capella. Green comes in for Gorden. And it's Rivers in for James Harden. Paul outside. With a floater, he lays it in. And the Rockets lead by nine.
Just a great hustle play there. Energy and passion. This is what you play the game for.
Lynn kicks to Leonard. Lays it up and banks it in.
Love the aggressiveness. Kawhi very active, very focused on the job at hand.
And here is Paul. 14 points from him the last game against Miami.
And made a big mark at the free throw line as well. He got himself to the strike a lot and cashed in when he had his chances.
A nice shot by Lynn. And now it's only a 5-point Rocket lead.
And Lynn is just fearless, always looking to get as close to the bucket as he can.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And P.J. Tucker, Greg, a rugged physical defender at the forward.
And here's the guy, second-round pick back in 06. Spent five seasons playing abroad before making his return to the association. Now he's a seasoned veteran and not shy about holding his teammates accountable, especially defensively.
First one falls. Some smaller players spend most of their time on the perimeter. Others really sacrifice, Steve, their bodies to make plays inside.
I think some of the small guys that get in there, like you said, is Kyrie Irving, one of the best at finishing. Kemba Walker, Mike Conley, Isaiah Thomas, Steph Curry. Some of these smaller guys who don't mind throwing their body into the paint.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Anunoby passes to Leonard. Again, Toronto. And so here is Houston. 4-point game. Shumpert against Lynn. Outside jumper. And Tucker has it in the corner. Good on the three-point shot. Tucker's got 12 in the game.
Good look by Shumpert. Right on the money.
Toronto's gone 3-6, 50% from deep so far tonight. Lynn against Rivers. Lynn finds Leonard, and out of bounds as the Rockets gain possession. As we approach the playoffs, let's see how the East is shaping up. We'll look at the Bucks. They are the favorite right now to lock up the number one seed come playoff time, sitting in first place right now and not looking like they, you know, are going to be slowing down at all. And, of course, there's Toronto right on their tail, vying to move up and take over if they get the chance.
And for the Raptors, they've had just the kind of season you knew they were capable of. I mean, they've got all the talent in the world, but how about maximizing it to the fullest?
That's been the key. This coaching staff knows what their strengths are. They play to those strengths. That's how they've gotten the most out of their talent.
Here's Lynn, and it's blocked. And that'll be Toronto as it goes out of bounds. Raptors retain possession. Leonard on the wing, guarded by Tucker. Five on the clock. Here's Gasol. Knocks down the 10-footer.
Marc Gasol is battling. Even with the defender all over him, he kept his focus.
Green dishes to Rivers. And Tucker kicks to Green. And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Too aggressive to start this game. That's already a couple fouls already in the first.
Siakam is checked in for Kawhi Leonard. Pass to Rivers. Just five on the clock. Back to Faried. And the layup's good off the glass.
Yeah, off to a strong start here early. 6 points off second chance buckets.
Raptors trail by 10. Outside, Lynn. Pass to Gasol. Buries it down low. Gasol's got his second basket of the game.
We know he can shoot it from the outside, but I love to see Mark down there on the block.
Here's Shumpert. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And guys, they've out and established a rhythm. And also their play calling has been on point.
Well, the two go hand in hand. Matching your strategy to your personnel is key.
The Rockets shooting their fifth attempt at the line in the game. He throw good. Amon Shumpert.
And for a guy as strong and as athletic as Shumpert is, he really doesn't get to the foul line enough, in my opinion.
Powell kicks to Ananobi. And 101 left here in the first quarter. Passes it to Siakam. And there's the call on Austin Rivers. That is his first foul of the game. .50 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Siakam.
And trailing here in the first, you'd like to see them be a little more aggressive on the offensive glass. And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
And another basket for Toronto.
Well, early on, neither team putting much emphasis on the defensive side.
No doubt. The offensive game planning on both sides has been effective early on.
8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. It's Rivers on the wing. Defended by Lynn. 6 on the shot clock. Rivers kicks to Faried. Shoots over Lynn. The shot's good from Faried. And the Rockets lead by 11. Lynn looking it over. Over Rivers.
Boy, he's focused. Rivers has the intensity and size to defend at a high level.
And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play. Rockets lead by 11. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. There's a great friendship between Melo, LeBron, Dwyane Wade, and Chris Paul, and Chris talked about where all that started.
It's been a sort of long relationship, you know, and obviously me, Bron, Melo, D. Wade have all really got really close. And that stems from the time with the Olympics, USA teams, and then just sharing a lot of the same likes and values and having kids and family and different things like that.
And you see that a lot nowadays, star players developing friendships and GA spending time with each other off the floor.
Yeah, hey, some people hate it because they want that bad blood you used to see, but no reason you have to hate someone to really compete against them.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And guys, we've seen the Rockets really take control here.
Hustling on that offensive glass, that's led to a number of second-chance points.
A fundamental part of basketball, taking advantage of guys who fail to block out.
We've got Jeremy Lin. He's out there with Norman Powell. Marc Gasol is out there with Anunoby. And it's Siakam in at the power forward position. So that's the five in the game for Toronto. And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, guys, Kyle Lowry is a player who has worked his way to stardom. He says, I still feel like I can be better. I'm never satisfied. My team is good, but I think the best I can be is a champion. There is no other goal in basketball. Guys?
DA, that's how you truly create a legacy.
And really, Lin has a terrific feel for this offense. Just seems to know whenever one of his guys is open.
And the foul called on OG Anunoby. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Well, he has to be careful now. He doesn't want to pick up that third foul this early.
So for the Rockets, Clint Capella comes in for P.J. Tucker. And Gordon subbed in for Green. Here's Shumpert. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Rivers with it. Powell's there. A nice shot by Rivers. Rivers has got five now.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Here's Powell. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Rivers passes to Gorden. And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter here. Six on the shot clock. Houston needs to get a shot off. Faried, and he uses the glass on the layup. He's got eight.
I mean, wonderful court vision. Sometimes Rivers gets locked in to finding his own shot. This time, finds the open man.
And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up.
In the corner, it's Gorden. And there's the call on Austin Rivers. That'll be his second foul of the game. Kyle Lowry, he's checked in for Toronto. And the Rockets making a change here as well. James Harden, he's checked in for Shumpert. Raptors trail by 13. And the Raptors call time here. Now, Steve, to play in the NBA, you need to be in peak shape. Talk about your diet and workout regimen back when you were in the game.
I will give myself an A-plus with workout regimen back in the day, Kevin.
Wow.
And then that diet part, I would say C-minus.
That was a D.
Yeah, you got it right. I would say a D. I try to give myself a little credit and say C-minus. I would say I love to see right now the cross workouts right now with guys doing Pilates, yoga, swimming. They're trying different things.
Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for the Raptors. Green comes in for Norman Powell. Chris Paul's checked in for the Rockets. Feeds it to Lowry. Fires from deep. Buries the long-range jumper. Lowry's got 7 points in the game.
Lowry gets more and more comfortable launching threes the longer he's in the league.
Lowry against Paul. Harden outside. Kicks it out to Paul. Takes the three. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Paul's got the lead up to 13 now for the Rockets.
The defense has to stay on Chris Paul. He has a quick trigger on the catch and shoot.
Outside Lowry. Out to Ibaka. Lowry up top. Raptors moving the ball around. Shot clock at 5. Releases. Lin's shot is off.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
The Rockets shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight. He's off on the first. Good on the second free throw. And here's Lynn. He'll bring it up for Toronto. They trail by 14. They've got the Pistons ahead of them in their next game in Detroit. That'll be just one game played away from home for them. He dishes it to Gasol. Yes! And a nice assist from Lynn. Lynn's got 3 assists now in this one. Rockets leading by 12. Harden scanning the floor. There's the triple, and the dunk by Faried.
Oh, taking it to the rack with power.
And hammering down the two-hand slam. Now Lowry, he has 7. Left side Gasol. It's stolen by Capella. Outside Gorden. Over in the corner, Paul. Harden outside. Back to Paul. 4 on the shot clock. And there's the call on Kyle Lowry. That's his first foul.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
The Raptors making a switch here. Leonard's checked in. Gorden against Leonard. Left side, Gorden.
Let's take a look at the numbers for Kawhi Leonard. The last 10 games, he has been on a heck of a run, averaging about 24 points, 4 assists, and 5 rebounds. So much of what this team does revolves around his offense.
He stacks up points. Reason why? Because that's his mindset. He wants to carry the load and clearly is successful at it.
Free throw good from Gorden. When you played on the road, Smitty, just how much did you hear comments from the crowd, home or away? But I'm guessing more on the road than at home.
Yeah, on the road you hear some interesting comments, Kevin, from a lot of the fans, and a lot of times I didn't want to drown it out. I wanted to hear, because it fueled me, and to get a chance to, I wouldn't say engage, I would tell young players not to engage. But the one thing I would do, Kevin, when you get going, you just kind of catch that fan, you get eye contact, and you give him that smile. And that's when I think you really attack them by your facial expressions.
Good explanation. Knocked loose. Gasol finds Lowry. And here is Green. Six to shoot. Leonard on the wing, guarded by Harden. Leonard, no luck.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Harden gets the bucket. Harden's got nine.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Harden against Leonard. And the basket for the fourth time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6.
This is what Kawhi provides. 100% of effort. Loves to take it right to you.
Harden up top, guarded by Green. Outside Gorden from downtown. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got 6 assists now in the game.
His temperature is rising. I mean, it is rising.
Raptors trail by 19. Outside Lowry. Kicks it to Gasol. It's stolen by Capella. Paul outside. Shot from 12. And it's Toronto with the rebound.
Yeah, the aggressive D inside leads to a missed opportunity there.
You know, he had terrific position. Does a good job of affecting the shot without fouling.
Raptors moving the ball around. Shot clock at 6. Leonard and another basket for Toronto.
He's done his job tonight scoring the basketball, but they've still been outplayed overall.
Paul kicks to Gorden. Back to Paul. Harden dishes to Paul. Harden against Green. And the basket by Harden. Harden's got 4 points this quarter.
And boy, has he picked it up since the start of the second. His shot's now starting to fall.
Leonard against Harden. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
Well, you know, the truth is, Leonard's been focused all night. Has an array of go-to moves and the endurance to keep on coming.
Paul kicks to Harden. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Now a chance, guys, to examine the rebounding numbers over the past months for Leonard.
And those are some numbers that he can't be happy about. His rebounding totals have taken a dip over the past few months. He's got to get back to giving the kind of effort on the boards we were seeing from him earlier.
Free throw good, James Harden. And the Rockets making a change here. Tucker's checked in. Harden hits them both. Raptors trail by 19. That's tipped. And the official signals a backcourt violation. Not very careful there. We get a break in the action, so let's take a look at the West and how the teams are stacking up. But take a look at the Warriors. Very strong season they've had, always at or near the top of the conference. And right now they're in first place in contention for that exactly where they want to be as they close in on the postseason. And checking out Houston, down 4 spots from them.
And you know, Houston, this season has been, it's been solid.
Connects again from distance.
The threes just don't stop with him. He's been a machine from beyond the arc ever since the start of the season.
He continues, doesn't he, to shoot his way up the history books and now sits solely by himself for third most threes in a season.
And the third place mark that has been passed was set by Curry back in 2015. Curry, of course, had several higher marks to aim for, but the third spot on the three list has been claimed.
Green, he's checked in for the Rockets. The pass to Ibaka. Outside Lowry. Clock at 6. Leonard, the pass to Gasol. Tries again. Green with the block.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
The dish now to Harden. Puts up a three. Drills the three-pointer. Harden's got a couple of three-pointers in the second for Houston.
And it's another James Harden special we're witnessing here tonight. I think this fella's got some game.
Leonard against Green. And Leonard gets it to go. Leonard's got 14.
He's been locked in all quarter, really finding his rhythm. When you think back to 2014, Kawhi was named an All-Star, Defensive Player of the Year, Finals MVP, broke out as a true superstar.
Lowry kicks to Leonard. It doesn't go for him. And the Rockets take it the other way. They'll be off to Boston for a meeting with the Celtics after this one. And that game will be game two of three straight on the road.
He pulls off the Houdini to make that catch and slam it through.
Stupendous alley-oop. Smitty, as you were saying about Leonard, only two other players in league history had obtained all three of those honors in a single season.
And those other two, Jordan and Hakeem Olajuwon, have been the only ones to do it. But Leonard did it at a very young age. Maybe the most amazing thing, Leonard's still just entering his prime.
That's tipped, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Green, and the Raptors with some changes. Siakam is checked in for Gasol, and it's Powell in for Danny Green. And a switch here also for Houston. Rivers checked in. A minute 42 left to play here in the second quarter. Six to shoot. Harden inside the three-point line. Busts the J after the cagey pass fake. Harden's got 21.
And each bucket at this point feels like a backbreaker.
Showing no mercy. Double-digit lead and still putting it on him.
Lowry can't get it to go.
In this first half, he has really fallen in love with the three. So far, not paying dividends.
Green kicks to Rivers. 103 left here in the second. From deep, Harden. Yes, indeed, it is good. He's now 8 for 14.
Three triples for him this quarter, four overall.
And so Lowry will bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. Pass to Leonard. Over Green. Falls back and drains the fadeaway jumper. 16 points for Kawhi Leonard.
And Kevin, they started the game shooting it so well. I'm surprised they haven't continued. They've got to get back to their strength.
And here's Harden for three. Here's Capella. And there's the bucket. Stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Capella's got four this quarter.
Guys, he's having a ball out there. I mean, we knew going in that he'd have an advantage on the glass, but I didn't think he could be this dominant. What a difference.
And he's not going to back off. Even with that big lead, he's going to get more motivated to keep stretching out their lead.
And getting going here in the second quarter, his second three-pointer of the game.
Here is Harden. He's got 24. No good on the last second attempt there. James Harden getting it done for Houston. He has really delivered at the offensive end. He's torched them for 24 points so far. And don't go away. We'll be right back.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is our halftime show. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. James Harden led the way in the first half. He ended up with 24 points, 6 assists, and 1 rebound. He's definitely heated up over the last few games, and we're seeing some of that same recipe here tonight. Kenny, what'd you think about the Rockets?
What we're seeing with James Harden, Ernie, is endurance. He's been the man. He's expected to do it every single night. And looking at the first half, he's only getting better. More relentless, more refined, and more capable of controlling the game.
Shaq, let's get your insight on Toronto.
Way too soft in the paint defensively. They were all late on their rotation. Obviously, that's a recipe for getting cooked. And you know I like eating that barbecue chicken. They got to do better, Ernie.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See everybody with Kevin Harlan.
Welcome back to Toronto, where the gigantic CN Tower dominates the skyline. Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. An exceptional performance so far from James Harden.
Yeah, scoring consistently from range. He really lit it up there in the first half.
Yeah, the defense has to adjust, extend out to him in the second half, and that could create a lot of floor spacing.
Toronto's gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight, 5 of 12. And on the floor for Mike D'Antoni starting the second half. The engine of this team, Paul and Harden in the backcourt. E.J. Tucker is out there with Gorden, and it's Capella in at the 5 down low. Ibaka, the pass to Siakam. Just 5 on the clock. Shoots over Tucker. Siakam, good. Siakam's got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for the Raptors. Green against Harden. Here's Tucker. Off target from outside. The Raptors shooting indicative of smooth offensive play. Up at 60%. They're a machine from the floor. Here's Leonard. And stolen by Gorden. Pass to Harden. Deflects the pass. And it's out of bounds to the Rockets as Houston retains possession.
Yeah, tremendous hustle just to get a hand on that one.
Reads the play, quick reaction, almost comes up with that steal.
Paul outside, and the dunk by Capella.
And watching Chris distribute the basketball, you can see he has a sixth sense for where to go.
And a tremendous Unleash Chaos replay coming to you courtesy of Under Armour Hover Havoc.
Out of bounds.
And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paul. And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Lowry kicks to Siakam. A three-pointer off the mark. Rockets shooting an impressive 65%, having their way with this defense. Harden gets the bucket. Harden's got 26.
They are just killing them on the interior.
The Raptors have gone 1-3 since starting the second half. And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That's foul number 2 for him. Just a little over 90 seconds gone in the third quarter. No stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a three-point play. That one's on Eric Gorden.
Strength, body control, and focus. Kawhi showing it all right there.
The Raptors shooting their first free throw this game.
Shooting one.
And with Kawhi Leonard, he just does everything well on the floor. Offense, defense, rebounding, runs the floor. I mean, he is one of the more complete players in our league. He can completely take over a game on both ends.
And Tucker kicks to Gorden. Lowry against Paul. Back to Gorden. A three-pointer off the mark. And Greg, with Kawhi, started as a defensive stopper, but he now is so much more than that.
I mean, he's got a great outside shot, that pull-up jumper, the turnarounds and the post. He has the complete repertoire. You never would have thought he was only viewed as a defense guy, once upon a time, but was already a fantastic player. But this is a guy that continues to just add to his game.
Harden against Green. Harden right side over Green. And, yep, finally drops after rolling around the rim. Harden's got 4 points in the quarter.
And Harden proving why he's an elite ball handler, absolutely cutting the D to pieces with his moves.
And the Raptors call time here.
And, look, you never want to see a team gut you this way. Really a good timeout.
Some of this is just a matter of toughness, a willingness to play physical inside, something we're not seeing.
Well, small forwards that can rebound the ball, such an asset to any team in the NBA, with now a look at the top rebounding wingmen. The fourth spot held by Kawhi Leonard.
And maybe they're not the biggest or strongest players in the front court, but that hasn't limited their ability to get in there and mix it up and come up with a lot of rebounds night in and night out.
But this group, they all play big, and the numbers they're able to put up on the glass makes them so valuable.
Lowry finds Leonard, and stolen by Gorden. Shoots the three. Siakam pulls it in. Siakam's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Passes it to Lowry. Now Ibaka. Shoots over Capella. And again, Toronto no luck.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
His teammates recognize that he has the hot hand going. That's why they get him the ball every chance they get.
Ball against Lowry. Poked loose. Leonard on the wing, defended by Gorden. Just 4 to shoot. And that one's good. Leonard's got 21 in the game.
And just carrying over from his last game. Completely dialed in. You can sense his confidence.
I totally agree. Heat check after heat check. He realizes, man, I'm still hot.
Oh, such a beautiful pass to set that one up.
Yeah, the pass might have been pretty, but the finish was angry. And here we go. Paul heading to the hoop. Drops in the breakaway layup. Paul's got 7 points in the game.
The quickness of Chris Paul isn't limited to just his offense. He is an amazing defender who can really rack up the steals.
The pass to Leonard. From down in the low post, it goes. Leonard's got 7 now in this quarter.
And his stroke has been dead on from the outside. I mean, inside, outside, it just doesn't matter.
Gorden against Leonard. Green deciding where to go with it. Dishes to Lowry. Pass to Siakam. He kicks it to Leonard. 5 to shoot. Over Gorden. They get it back. Outside Lowry. 3-pointer. It's no good. He's now 4 of 9 from the field. To the paint. Here's Capella. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. He's got 18.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
Leonard against Gorden. Leonard draws the double inside, and he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
It's amazing everything Leonard gives you, including the eyes to find the open man.
Green against Harden. With some arc, and that's 2 points on the layup. Harden's got 32 points.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
Paul against Lowry. To the inside, Leonard. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a 3-point play chance for him.
Nice look there from Kyle Lowry, the Villanova Wildcat.
The Raptors have gone 1-for-1, making their previous attempt at the line. A new group in now for the Raptors. Marc Gasol checked in for Ibaka. OG Anunoby comes in for Pascal Siakam. Norman Powell's checked in for Green. And it's Jeremy Lin in for Kyle Lowry. Houston also making some changes. Kenneth Faried, he's checked in for Clint Capella. Shumper comes in for James Harden. And it's Austin Rivers in for Chris Paul.
He's an NBA champion and finals MVP in 2014. Kawhi continues to impact the game at the highest level.
Gasol with the steal. Now the Raptors moving it up. Here's Lin. Second chance shot, and Gasol lays it in. Gasol's got 10 points in the game.
Creating a size mismatch in close. That's the kind of thing you're working for.
Gorden kicks to Rivers. To the inside. Here's Shumpert. Gasol with the rebound. Gasol's got his fourth rebound in this one. A three from Leonard. Rockets with the rebound. Tucker's got four rebounds in this game. He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, it seems every season new records are set for the number of three-pointers made and attempted. It's proven to be successful, and of course, it is a copycat league. It's hard to know why it took so long for everyone to catch on, but now that they have, the effects continue to ripple throughout the league.
They sure have, David. Thank you. Gorden deciding where to go with it. And he uses the glass on the layup. He's got 14. And here are the Raptors now. Outside, Lin. Pass to Leonard. Kicks to Gasol. Shoots over Tucker. And the Raptors miss again.
And you see why his reputation is so strong defensively. He allows no separation.
And so many defenses are not designed to take away the mid-range jumper. But he's given nothing away.
Back to Gorden. Clock at six. Takes a three. And it's Toronto with the rebound. Gasol's got five rebounds tonight. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum. Oh, and look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that deuce.
And Shumper kicks it to Tucker. Passes it to Gorden. It's Rivers on the wing. Here's the three. Some solid defense there from Lin. Toronto's gotten off to a very slow start from three-point range in the second half. They're 0-for-4. And Marc Gasol, a force on both ends of the floor. You forget, you know, Greg, that he's won a Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, you know, Gasol doesn't really wow you on defense with what he does. I mean, he gets blocks, but it's really his positioning and his rotations are what make him so great. Always involved in plays, and he just seems to be able to protect the rim and a terrific team defender.
Gerald Green, he's checked in for Gorden.
One shot, behind the lanes.
And the free throw, no good. Houston's gotten one of six three-pointers to drop since coming out of the locker room at halftime. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
One shot. I mean, he's extremely confident and aggressive. Rivers loves to take it up inside.
And Austin Rivers out of Duke, an elusive 6'4 combo guard.
I mean, a great handle, and he's found most of his offensive success with this development as a long-range shooter. It's gotten to the point now where you want him to put it on the deck.
One shot.
And that one misses.
Austin Rivers, a lottery pick in 2012 after 1 year at Duke. He wasn't ready at first, needed time to round out his game. Now he's established himself as a quality guard.
Now here's Shumpert, guarded by Powell. Here's Rivers. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. Rivers has got 9.
Ball handling is one of Rivers' strong points, being able to get where he wants on the court and create and finish.
Outside Leonard. He dishes it to Powell. Inside, got a piece of it. Out of bounds, Houston takes possession. You know, Austin Rivers has earned more minutes through his commitment at the defensive end of the floor.
That's how you do it, Kevin. Solidify your spot, then you can build confidence offensively.
And Shumpert kicks to Green. Knocks it loose. Leonard with the steal. Ananobi passes to Powell. That shot, no good. Shumpert with some nice D. The drive by...
Oh, wow!
Watch your head!
That's a beautiful jam.
And, guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, yeah. That's for sure. Here's Leonard. And, oh, boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
And with a quick break in the action, here are some numbers for Len. Putting up about 10 points a night, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. And the numbers won't wow you, but I like the effort he brings to the table each and every night.
You need guys who understand their roles. Carry them out without complaint. Everything he does is for the team.
And he makes the first. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
It's interesting. No free throw attempts for him in the first half. He's finally pushing the action and reaping the reward.
Shumpert dishes to Rivers. And Tucker has it in the corner. Cans it from downtown. Tucker's got 15 points.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
And there's the call on Austin Rivers. That will get him his 4th foul of the game, and due to the bonus, we'll head to the line for 2.
When you watch Ananobi play, he does so much well. Makes his teammates better. Not easy to do as a young wing player. He's a fantastic passer and does a very good job of reading the play. 2.
He's off on the first.
And the potential Ananobi has is exciting. Has the athleticism, the shooting touch, and the drive to keep improving.
And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time.
And they came out of the locker room after halftime with a much more physical approach than what we saw in that first half.
Count it. He's got 6.
And so far, going for more of an inside presence here in the second half, getting away from the three-point shot.
And Shumpert kicks to Rivers. Over in the corner, Green. Knocked loose. Fast break, Toronto. Here's Powell, and the dunk by Powell.
And a late reaction by the defense makes that one a no contest.
You know, he got out before people could turn their heads, and he's already gone with no hesitation.
To the middle. James Harden getting it done for the Houston Rockets. And his big game just keeps getting bigger. That quarter sees him get over 30 points. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
This is why you preach teamwork. Some of the most spectacular plays are the ones where guys are feeding off one another.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. And for the Rockets, they're shooting so well, the offensive execution has been brilliant, 66% from the field. We've got Ananobi. McCaw is out there with Jody Meeks. Then it's Miller, and it's Boucher in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the five out there for the Raptors. Boucher with the rebound.
That was against good defense. He tried to sneak it in, though. We've seen him do it plenty of times.
Ananobi kicks to Meeks. Back to Ananobi. The Raptors need to get a shot off. No good on the three.
And this is what he gives you, the ability to contest the shot without fouling.
Perimeter defense at a premium these days. You see the value in this kind of effort.
Rivers with it. Shot from 12. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors will take it the other way.
And he throws it right out of bounds. Careless mistake.
Siakam is checked in for Ananobi. Raptors shooting certainly a key for them in this one. 55% from the field. McCaw kicks to Siakam, and there's the pass to Miller. When you look around the NBA, are there any small issues you think could grow into bigger issues, Steve, going forward?
Well, I think the one issue right now is what are teams doing at the end of the year versus trying to stay competitive and win games or trying to look possibly down in the NBA draft lottery.
Right.
I think that's one of those problems that we have to address. I think also small markets, I don't think that's much of a problem if you have organizations in the forefront. Winning is in the forefront. I don't think whether a small market or big market, guys do look at that far as endorsements, but I don't think that'll be a problem.
He hits the second from the line. And so it's Rivers with it. He'll bring it up for the Rockets. They've only given up 1 point in the fourth quarter. That's tipped. Fast break, Toronto. Meeks leading the charge. McCaw, the pass to Siakam. And he goes in for the dunk.
Whoa, quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and offensively.
Terrific defensive instincts to come away with that one, and he showed no hesitation in how he completed that transition opportunity.
You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Clark, the pass to Hartenstein. Houston moving it around. Clock at six. There's Green with the three. Knocks down the three ball.
And those aren't the type of three-point opportunities that you can allow in the NBA.
Here's McCaw. He's guarded by Rivers. McCaw kicks to Meeks. And another basket for Toronto. The Rockets have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Outside, Green. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. NBA wants to keep things competitive, and one way to do that was to make some changes, Steve, to the draft lottery odds. Do you think it'll be enough?
You know, I think it's the right call for them. I think the bottom three teams all have the same odds for the top three spots now.
Two shots.
And it'll be much more even to distribute the odds for the back half of the lottery.
And the first one drops. Chris Paul, he's checked in for Houston. Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line. The Raptors have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. Now, here's Meeks, guarded by Shumpert. Pass to McCaw. Pass to Siakam. And it's off target, not sure why he took that one.
Yeah, not a great shot there, especially when you got a lockdown defender guarding you.
You know, there's no shame in passing out in that situation. Leave your ego at the door.
And the call will be against Patrick McCaw. That's his first foul. And so it's Houston with it. They've only given up 5 points here in the fourth quarter. Just 5 on the clock. From outside the arc, that shot off. And Toronto will come the other way. On the wing, Miller. McCaw kicks to Boucher. Meeks passes to Boucher. Connects from 3-point range.
This is where we're going in the NBA right now. Stretch bigs.
Now here's Paul, guarded closely. Got a piece of it. Fast break Toronto. Meeks leading the charge. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors able to retain possession here. And a chance now to look at the schedule for Houston. On Sunday, they'll be facing Kyrie Irving and the Boston Celtics. And then on Tuesday, they'll be matching up against Kyle Lowry and the Toronto Raptors.
Yeah, and for the game with the Mavericks, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with the win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top.
Rockets leading by 22. Passes it to Hartenstein. He kicks it to Shumpert. Now here's Paul. Offline with the baseline jumper. On the wing, Miller. Here's McCaw. And there's the pass to Boucher. Here's McCaw. Shot clock at 5. The tray. Boucher's shot is off. Houston's gone 1 of 2 from 3-point range here in the fourth. Here's Paul. Sweet little floater.
Chris Paul has such a gentle touch on his floaters. There's no way the defense can get to that shot.
Raptors have gone 4 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth.
Keep coming. Shoot it.
Here's McCall, defended by Paul. Green against Miller. Outside jumper. Pass to Hartenstein. Outside jumper. Fires the 3. tipped away.
Yeah, good job. Just staying alert there, snatching up that long rebound.
It's Miller on the wing. Pass to McCaw. When it comes to flagrant fouls, do you think the difference, Steve, between flagrant one and flagrant two is being called correctly for the most part?
I do, Kevin. I think we always have gray areas and when you start to look at rules, but for the most part, I think they're getting the flagrant run and the flagrant two, you know, I think they're getting it right.
Meeks outside. A three-pointer is right on target.
I'll tell you, even though he's a question mark from range, you still have to defend him.
Pass to Hartenstein. Kicks to Shumpert. To the paint. A nice shot by Hartenstein.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
The pass to Boucher. Miller inside. Battles through traffic and lays it in.
He turned on the jets. As soon as he got that screen, it went right to the hole. Great decision making there.
Paul passes to Hartenstein. He kicks it to Shumpert. Whistle blows, basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
One shot.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
One shot, gentlemen.
And that one falls for Shumpert. Smitty, every so often we'll hear about a team holding a players-only meeting. You've been there, I'm sure. You've gone through that. What exactly goes on in those discussions?
You know, Kevin, when you hear players-only meeting, something's going wrong with the team. Right. And obviously, we meet all the time.
Two
but
shots.
When there's specific, in quotation, a players-only meeting, there's a lot of things are going wrong with the team, with individuals, with the coaches or general managers. They are trying to find a way to hash it out, and those are never good.
You know, when Chris Paul came to the Rockets, a lot of people questioned if he and James Harden would be able to share the ball. Both known for being ball-dominant guards, I think you'd have to say it's worked out pretty well.
Now, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
Free throw, good, Paul. And I think Chris Paul never comfortable with that ball dominant label, Greg. He'd never played with another guard who could create, certainly on the level of Harden.
No doubt about it. I mean, Mo Pete, J.J. Redick, guys who were great shooters, but really more off the ball players. Chris needed to be that kind of a playmaker, but with Harden, he has someone just as gifted at creating baskets for himself and others.
Ball against Lowry to the inside, stolen by Tucker, and it's the Rockets on the break. Paul, no one around him. He clangs that one off the back iron and down it falls.
So much sharper, so much more efficient with his shot this half. Just taking what the defense allows.
Powell kicks to Lowry. Player podcast, something we're hearing more of, and it's a growing trend. Good idea, or do you think it could get some guys in trouble?
Kevin, well, some guys, it does a good job of helping their brand, and we love to see guys getting a chance to do other things off the court. And then there are some guys who get a little loose and they reveal some secrets or they say some things they wish they could take back. So I think it all comes down to the individual. You gotta understand media before you try to jump out and start doing these podcasts.
Well said.
extended the league, this has been a great peer for him offensively.
And here is Powell. Ananobi passes to Powell, looking to end the run. The Rockets pull it in. Shumpert's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Green kicks to Paul. Takes the 13-footer, and the Rockets getting another bucket right there.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Now Lowry. Pass to Gasol. Over to the left wing. Puts up a three. And again, no good by Toronto.
Yeah, it just seems whatever they do, nothing's working right now to stop the bleeding.
It takes an effort on both ends of the floor, and you have to find the right matchups to exploit.
Well, the pace, the big plays they're making, this is a statement run right here.
Hard to remember the last time they've missed. These guys are having fun right now.
Here's Boucher. In close, he hits it. Boucher's got 7 points here in this quarter.
Taking a workmanlike approach inside, that's the shot you want.
Houston's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Houston moving it around. The shot's good from Paul.
What can you say about Chris that hasn't been said before? A two-way Hall of Fame talent.
The Raptors have gotten more than 58% of their attempts to go down for them in the fourth quarter. They're 7 of 12. And there's the foul. It'll go on P.J. Tucker. That's foul number 2 for him. The NBA is so financially stable right now, Steve. What's it been like watching this growth for the league overall?
You know, I've loved it because I think the partnership has been phenomenal. The league is growing both for players and also organization. They've done a nice job of getting a chance to hammer out some of these issues to making it worthwhile financially for the league and also financially for the players.
And this is a guy that can get you stops, aggressive on the defensive end.
Also doing a good job of tracking the ball, contesting the mid-range jumper as well.
Capella kicks to Paul. Pass to Shumpert, and he gets the whistle for the 3-second call. Rivers, he's checked in for Paul. Toronto's shooting has been just great in the fourth quarter, 54%.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Rockets.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. And on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And when it's all said and done here, this will mark their 38th W on the year.
And in a 3-game season series, they take the first two, and certainly they've had the edge in this matchup.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys, and looking at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Clint Capella.
And you have to love the effort he put forth on the glass. He played with a fire no one else could match as he chased down those rebounds. And how much longer are they going to keep that foot on the accelerator?
Well, this is less about winning the game now and more about making a bold statement.
Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Lowry kicks to Gasol. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Powell, gets himself open and drills it.
And that's what you like to see right there, a solid move to give himself some room and take it inside.
Rivers with it. So we see Houston taking the W here. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much with Chris Paul. Chris, a very convincing win, and that doesn't happen often in this league. So what do you take from this?
You know, one thing that our coaching staff keeps stressing to us every night is that it's about us. You know, so regardless of score, we got to continue to try to get better because we impose our will on the defensive end. The sky's the limit.
Well, the focus was there tonight, Chris. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.